دكتور ممدوح النحاس، أستاذ ورئيس قسم الأمراض البطنة بكلية طب بورسعيد. Diabetic dyslipidemia is an important topic because it lead to atherosclerosis that lead to coronary heart disease, stroke, peripheral arterial disease, etc. Dyslipidemia is very dangerous in diabetic subject because it is the leading cause for atherosclerosis. Diabetic dyslipidemia consists of hypertriglyceridemia, both in the fasting and postprandial state, decreased HDL and small dense LDL. Small dense LDL is more atherogenic, so we sometimes become confronted with diabetic patient with near normal serum cholesterol and the LDL level, but it is still very dangerous as the part is mainly formed of small dense LDL, which is more atherogenic. Why small dense LDL is more atherogenic? Because it is very small that can penetrate the endothelial wall very easily. It is more liable to oxidation. Also, it contain a larger amount of ApoB, which affect its binding to the LDL receptors and consequently lead to decrease clearance of LDL and increase concentration in the blood. The treatment of dyslipidemia is very essential. The first line in treatment of dyslipidemia is physical activity and lifestyle modification. Lifestyle consists of diet and exercise. Diet, we should restrict saturated fat and cholesterol intake. Encourage the intake of omega-3 fatty acid, which from its natural sources, which is fish, and increase vegetable and legumes consumption. Also, increased physical exercise is very essential, as these are two important factors in the control of dyslipidemia. The second item is control of blood glucose. Control of blood glucose is very essential because we know that triglyceride level are strongly affected by blood glucose level, and also a small dense LDL is related to hyperglycemia. When we achieve better control of blood glucose, this will lead to increase in the size of the LDL particle. Treatment of hypertriglyceridemia is a matter of debate because we can reduce the level of triglyceride by using fibrate, but the impact of this reduction on cardiovascular system is a matter of debate. The ADA 2018 recommend that triglyceride should be treated if it is increased more than 500 milligram per deciliter, and this to avoid or decrease the risk of pancreatitis, not to reduce cardiovascular event. Hypercholesterolemia is important to be treated. The ADA guidelines divide patient into patient below 40 years and patient above 40 years. In both group, if the patient had atherosclerotic heart disease, we should start with high intensity statin. If LDL decrease below 70 milligram per deciliter, this is good. If not, we have to use combination therapy, especially with ezetimibe. For patient without cardiovascular risk, we can use moderate intensity statin or high intensity statin in patient above 40 years of age. The combination therapy is important, and we should use combination of statin with ezetimibe as long as serum cholesterol or LDL cholesterol is above 70 milligram per deciliter. fibrate to statin combination is not recommended by the ADA unless triglycerides are very high. And thank you very much.